It's a move set to deliver a hit to the wealthy.
We voted for a reason.
It's just a long list of promises he's broken.
And a boost to the not so wealthy.
I don't care that the rich might miss out on their tax cuts.
I think the more you earn, the more tax you should pay.
The PM today pitching himself as a regular Robin Hood.
We run from the rich and give to the poor, that's right!
Albanese set to take a knife to stage three tax cuts.
This proposal will be all about supporting middle Australia. We know that there are cost of living pressures and we're determined to follow the Treasury advice to provide assistance to them.
At the same time, taking a knife to a key election promise.
I remember him looking straight into the eyes of the Australian people and saying, my word is my bond.
My word is my bond.
And I won't change the stage three tax cuts.
Anthony Albanese, more than 100 times with Jim Chalmers and his team, said they would leave these tax cuts untouched.
We haven't changed our position.
Our position hasn't changed.
On the stage three tax cuts. I noticed our opponents have not waited to see any detail, to see what the proposal is. They're just against it.
All the juicy details are set to drop tomorrow, but word has it the overhaul will leave everyone on under $150,000 better off, including those on less than $45,000, who were originally set to miss out. Those earning more than $150,000 will still get a tax cut, but it'll be slashed by as much as half.
Everybody's struggling out there, so, you know, I think the lower earners need more help.
Fans of the reform say it's necessary in the face of a cost of living crisis, some pushing for even more drastic action.
The current stage three tax cuts are blatantly unfair, and I reckon your average Australian thinks so too.
The stage three tax cuts overwhelmingly favour the top end.
But an enraged opposition has vowed to undo any changes due to take effect from July 1st if it wins the next election.
We're not prepared to give up on this, and we know that hard-working Australians who deserve to keep more of their money don't want us to give up on this.
My job is to do the right thing for the right reasons. That's what I will do.
National Senator Bridget McKenzie is here to tell us why Albo's got it all wrong. Bridget, the latest data shows 92% of Aussies earn under $150,000. Why should they share your rage?
Well, I think the concern is that Australians are sick and tired of prime ministers who say one thing before an election and then do the complete opposite after it. And I think it's really important to reflect on the fact that stage three is obviously part of a tranche of changes over a period of time, legislated back in 2019, to make our system fairer, recognising that those that got the immediate benefit and the cumulative maximum benefit of those changes were absolutely those low to middle income earners who got the major benefits. So it's the fact that these are structural changes which weren't just to serve Australian workers this year, but we're actually trying to deal with decade-long problems of bracket creep where, you know, Australians are working very, very hard and they're being pushed up into higher tax brackets and paying more of their own money to the government than they need to. And that situation's only going to get worse.
Senator, I was just going to say, look, I get the broken promise, and I understand that the words, my word is my bond, it's going to come back to haunt Anthony Albanese for a long time. But how angry are people really going to be that he broke this promise when they're getting more money back in their pocket?
Well, I think you've got to take a holistic look at this. I mean, the fact is by 2030, we're going to have a million more people in that higher tax bracket. The highest tax bracket being dealt with is actually people like school principals, like those in the construction industry, out in our suburbs, particularly in Melbourne and Sydney, who are also being hit with inflation and incredibly high interest rates and rent. They're raising kids and they're doing it tough. And so right now we have a system that was, you know, constructed back in the early 2000s, and it's not fit for purpose. So that's the issue. We want the structural reform, not just for this year's tax system, but for the decade to come, to make sure that more and more Australians aren't being slugged by tax rates simply by working hard and inflationary pressures drives them up into a higher tax bracket.
Bridget, so when this promise was initially made, the economy was in a very different place. Do you not think the cost of living crisis could kind of justify this shake-up?
Well, I think this shows, this reactionary pressure from the Labor government shows that whilst last year they told us they had a plan to deal with the cost of living crisis, they actually don't. And when you look across the government decision making, you see rents going through the roof. You can't find a house for love nor money in our regional capitals or our crowded suburbs, whilst they're bringing in another 1.5 million people to add to that pressure. Their energy bills are going through the roof. Their energy policy, similarly, is making that happen. So whilst they're saying they've got a plan, the fact that they're having to resort to this measure to break a promise, to actually overturn significant and needed structural changes to our tax system, shows that they never had a plan in the first place. And Australians absolutely deserve better from this government.
This puts you guys in a really interesting position. So your Liberal partners have vowed to undo the changes, undo any changes that Labor makes if you get elected at the next election, which will mean you would be removing the additional tax cut for everybody that they're about to receive who's earning under $150,000. Are you really going to go to the next election with a tax increase for everybody who's under $150,000?
Well, while taxes are always going to be lower under a Liberal National Coalition government, we know that. It's not just food and grocery, petrol, you know, rents and mortgages that have gone on through the roof under Labor. Taxes have gone up 27% as well in the last 18 months. So I can absolutely guarantee we won't be taking a high taxing policy to the next election.
Not quite my question, though. And the taxes are about to go down, especially for those people under $150,000. So they'll be taxing those people less than would have been in your plan. So will you be taking their tax cuts away if you win government next time?
We're absolutely committed to the structural reforms that we delivered in government because we believe that sets our tax system up and Australian workers for a much better deal over coming decades. And so that's what we're committed to.
So I'm absolutely sure that
we will be taking a lower taxing environment to the next election than Labor. And Australians already know it. Go on the street, talk to any country town, any suburb. Australians are not buying that this government has their back
I just want to be clear on this, because a lower taxing environment is a very big statement. That's a very broad sort of statement. And that could mean that it's a lower taxing environment, but not for you personally, this particular voter. So I just want to be really clear. Those people who are on $150,000 or less right now, who stand to get a bigger tax cut than they were expecting, at the next election, your plan is to take that tax cut off them, to increase their tax bill because you want to revert to the structural reform that you had in play that was legislated in 2019. Is that right?
So, Waleed, as you and I both know, and maybe not your viewers because National Press Club addresses aren't something most Australians tune into, but the Prime Minister will be unveiling the details and the specific details of these changes that caucus has just agreed to tomorrow. And so we'll obviously have much more to say once we see that detail. But what I do know is we are committed to a fairer tax system for all Australian workers. We demonstrated that in government. We put a raft of measures in place over a period of 6 years to achieve that for Australian workers. And we won't resile from continuing to focus on that goal.
Senator Bridget McKenzie, thanks for your time.
Always, mate.